nuclear energy has been around for 50 or 60 years. And I'll note that South Korea has a leading nuclear energy program as well. But there's really some great opportunities that we haven't realized yet in nuclear science. So TerraPower is pursuing several projects. First, there's our main project is the Natrium reactor. That's an advanced nuclear reactor. We also have a medical isotopes program that we call TPI or TerraPower isotopes. So for TPI, we are providing a nuclear isotope, actinium-225, to the pharmaceutical industry, which will be used in cancer-fighting drugs. So the medical isotopes business is really a great illustration of the opportunities we have in nuclear science. Most people think of nuclear energy when they think of nuclear, but there's many other benefits to us moving forward and innovating in nuclear science. Sure. So first, it's really a positive thing that there's so much investment and so many new companies entering advanced nuclear energy and SMRs. Because we really need more nuclear energy to mitigate climate change. We'll have a lot of fossil generated power that is reaching retirement age. And we're replacing that somewhat with wind and solar, but wind and solar are intermittent sources of power. They can change throughout the day or change seasonally. So nuclear is really a great complement to wind and solar in an emission-free grid. We think nuclear should account for 20 to 30% of the future power generation on a carbon-free grid. So we see wind and solar continuing to grow as fossil retirements occur. But again, we see a future that has in developed economies, like the US and in South Korea and the rest of Asia, we think we'll need 20 to 30% nuclear. So that's a big opportunity. And it's a reason that, many new companies need to enter this space. Now, we do think TerraPower is the leader in advanced nuclear. One big difference in our plants, like the Natrium plant versus today's technology, the technology in Korea is a pressurized water reactor today. It's very safe. It's been very, very dependable. That is like the existing technology in the U.S. But it's a high pressure system. These are very large plants. And TerraPower believes that it's time to move to a new technology. Natrium is not a water-cooled plant like the plants in Korea today. It's a plant that's cooled with liquid sodium. So it is cooled by liquid sodium metal. And that allows it to be a low-pressure plant, which should reduce construction costs by having lower pressure piping and components. It should also allow for economic savings due to having less structural steel and less concrete per gigawatt generated. So in addition to things like the cost savings, Natrium also employs molten salt storage. So the reactor makes heat with fission, like today's reactors. But because we use molten sodium as a coolant, that operates at a higher temperature than today's reactors. Today's reactors in South Korea operate at about 300 centigrade. Natrium operates closer to 500 centigrade. And that's really ideal for working with a energy storage technology called molten salt storage. So molten salt storage has been thoroughly proven in the solar industry already, because solar plants need to store their energy for when there are clouds or changes in the electricity demand. And so this is a proven technology that operates at about 500 centigrade, the same temperature as natrium. So by incorporating molten salt storage into natrium, it really makes for an ideal power generation and storage system for the grid that we'll see in the 2030s and the 2040s, because that will be a grid that has a growing penetration of wind and solar, which are intermittent. It will also be a grid that sees a large amount of fossil retirement. So when we lose things like coal generation, which runs 24/7, and we're adding wind and solar, which is intermittent, it creates kind of a problem. And natrium really addresses that problem by providing, you know, that 24/7 generation that coal is known for, but then it also has this energy storage aspect, which lets it change its power very quickly. Was there a question? No? Okay. So natrium, its nominal power output is 345 megawatts. So that's about one third of the size of the large plants in South Korea today. So there's more places on the grid where you could install natrium generation. But because of the energy storage capability, natrium can increase its power quickly from 345 megawatts to 500 megawatts. And that's really going to be a benefit on a grid that has lots of wind and solar. Nuclear energy has a great safety record, really. If you were to compare nuclear energy quantitatively to other forms of energy in developed economies like the US and South Korea, nuclear has the best safety record, really. The 92 reactors that have been operating in the U.S. for 50 years, or the reactors in South Korea that have been operating for decades, have great safety records. So, you know, first we need to point out that nuclear energy has been very safe for our countries. It's been a safe and emission-free source of electricity. But natrium will have an even higher level of safety for several reasons. One, because it's a low pressure system, that will improve our economics. But also, when you have a low pressure, it's safer. It allows you to have lighter components and piping. Natrium also has the ability to cool itself without outside sources of electricity. So if you think about Fukushima, in that scenario, the plant shut down very quickly following the earthquake. But the problem with Fukushima was that the reactor couldn't keep itself cool without external electricity. And we remember when the tsunami occurred, that destroyed their diesel generators. And so they had a situation they call station blackout, where there was no power supply for cooling pumps. So today's reactors around the world do need offsite electric power in an emergency like that. Natrium will not need offsite electric power. We say that natrium is walk-away safe, meaning for any unexpected event you can think of, the plant will not only shut itself down very quickly and the nuclear reaction will stop, but natrium will also be able to cool itself without any source of outside electric power. It will use air cooling. So basically, there will be some chimneys around the reactor vessel, where air cooling removes that small amount of heat from the reactor. No operator action is required, and this cooling will occur for that we call it an infinite coping period. That situation will continue as long as necessary until power can be restored to the site. Okay, so our first commercial reactor for natrium is being built in the state of Wyoming in the U.S. This decade. So the objective is really to have commercial demonstration of natrium in the 2020s, because in the 2030s, there's going to be a great need for many natrium reactors in the U.S. and around the world. So this first project is very important. It's happening with significant U.S. government investment. TerraPower was the awardee for a program called the Advanced Reactor Demonstration Program. So half the cost of the first plant is being covered by the U.S. Department of Energy. The other half of the funding is coming from private investment. And I do want to note that, you know, our lead investor is Bill Gates, but also in our most recent fundraising last year, SK, I see Mr. Lee is on the line with us. Last year, SK joined the Gates organization in leading our fundraise last year, which we really appreciated. And also in that fundraise, HD Hyundai, Korea Shipbuilding, participated. So we were very excited to have this Korean investment because Korea has a long history of safe production of nuclear energy. And also there's a very strong relationship between the U.S. and South Korea, which was really renewed by President Yoon. President Yoon and President Biden have had multiple meetings. The U.S. and South Korea are cooperating on the international stage. And also the two presidents have indicated that we should cooperate in nuclear energy. So we were really pleased to have this Korean involvement. The phase of the project right now is we have completed our site studies. So we've done the geotechnical drilling on the site in Wyoming, and we've shown that the site is really, really ideal for the power plant construction. And now the design process is underway. We have 800 design engineers working on the natrium design, and construction will start in 2024, and the plant will be online producing electricity in 2030. Again, we expect a need for many of these plants in the 2030s. So even before the first natrium is done, we expect additional natrium project starts. And with PacifiCorp is the owner of the first plant in Wyoming. PacifiCorp and TerraPower are also performing a study to build five additional reactors in the Mountain West part of the U.S. So that's in Wyoming and Utah, because in that region we have a significant amount of coal power that's scheduled for retirement. We have a significant addition of wind. It's a great area for wind, but as I explained earlier, you need to complement that wind with something that runs 24/7 and with storage. And natrium has both that 24/7 generation and storage. So, we look forward to building natrium reactors around the world after this first deployment in Wyoming and Utah. And that's why it's great, too, to be partnering with entities in South Korea, not just because of the private investment they're bringing to the project, but also due to the significant industrial capabilities and nuclear experience in South Korea SK and Hyundai HD can help us maximize the deployment of natrium around the world. Yes, I think you're referring to the HALEU fuel supply. So HALEU is high assay, low enriched uranium. Nearly all of the advanced reactor designs that are being considered around the world use a higher enrichment of fuel called HALEU. So, you know, the reactors in South Korea today use low enriched uranium, which is uranium enriched up to about 5%. HALEU fuel can be enriched as high as 20%. Still very safe, but gives the reactors greater capabilities. So today in the U.S., there is not currently a supply of HALEU. So our plans originally were to for the first plant in Wyoming. That reactor was going to begin with fuel that was procured from Russia. Now, the U.S. Department of Energy has, for a long time, had a plan to create HALEU capability in the U.S. That's always been the plan. But for a short time, we were going to rely on the Russian supply. Now, after the Russian attack on Ukraine, TerraPower decided very quickly that we did not want to use Russian fuel on our reactor in Wyoming. And we made that very clear publicly. So since then, we've been working with the Department of Energy to accelerate the creation of HALEU production capacity in the U.S. There has been significant funding appropriated by Congress now for HALEU production. And the DOE is now in the process of a request for quotation to several different current enrichment companies. And so we have a lot of good progress here, and we expect the HALEU supply in the US to support our new schedule. Now, in December, we did note that, mainly due to this HALEU supply issue, that our end date for the completion of the first natrium reactor would move by two years delayed. Again, we're happy with the progress the Department of Energy is making to catalyze the U.S. industry to create this capacity.